And hello everybody, it is Rude, welcome back. So I'm gonna make this quick. This is gonna be a very short video. Somebody asked, how do you level up faster? How do you level up in this game, and how can you reach around max level and also around the higher levels? Let's just keep it simple. If you hear my fan in the background, I'm sorry. Let's just keep it simple. How to reach into season 2. Let's keep it simple. And then we'll probably go off into more in the last section. So either way, when you start Vindictus, this is what I'm going to recommend. Like, when you start Vindictus, you are going to have a mission over there in the Mercenaries Outpost. It's going to be your first mission. It is going to be a tutorial mission, just so you know. It's going to be a tutorial mission. And when you get that mission, pretty much skim through all of the text, skip through all of the story, because you're just trying to level, right? You're not really trying to read into the story. The lore of this game, it's really not that interesting, honestly. If you want to read into it, they have notes and pretty much summaries on the internet if you want to read about it. But this is for people who just want to speed level and just get higher in level. Usually I never say rush level. As you can see, I'm only level 84 right now, and the reason I haven't leveled and went to 90 is because I'm not in any rush whatsoever, and I can be level 80, 84, and I have more attack than people that are level 90 that rush level, and I feel special about that, but that's just me. So either way, when you get into there and you get the mission and you go to the tutorial mission, it's pretty simple. Pretty much when you finish the tutorial mission, you're going to want to do this every single time. You're going to click slash and then leave, and that literally will end the mission. But do know you have to have the text right there, the notification saying that you have completed, so on and so on. When you see that, you will be able to leave and just skip the entire long loading of you of the quest and of you being done with the quest. Do know there is three bosses in season one that you can, no, three quests in season one that you cannot do that, or else it will completely fail the mission. And that is, let's go over there real quick. That is, it's with the polar bear. It's with the polar bear. Now let's go look real quick. So, when you get over here, this boss here, the throne, the white tyrant, yeah, the white tyrant, you cannot press slash leave to leave, because it won't allow it. If you do that, you are going to actually completely fail the mission, which you do not want to do. If you want to speed level, you don't want to do a same mission over twice for some stupid fuck up. And also, this is one more thing that I'm going to recommend. If you want to level in this game, and I mean level in this game, I'm keeping this straightforward. If you want to level in this game, do not level with people. Let's put it like that. Simple. If you're doing your quests, do not level with your quests. Okay, let's show you the rest. There is this boss here, Dethrone the White Tyrant. There is, hold up, let me go to the forest over here. There is this boss. Where is he? Yeah, this boss here. You're gonna don't do slash leave with him. If you do, you'll fail a mission. And then there is one more, which is over here in the rooms, and it is pretty much the Temple Plain, the Trampled Plains. Those are pretty much the only three missions that will really require you to stay there for the entire thing. Now, continuing it, if you want to level in this game, and you're just trying to level, and you really want to hit at least like around level 80 or higher, whatever, it only takes a day to hit level 90. That's if you know life the game. Do not play with people. I know it's fun to play with your friends and etc and etc. Y'all can level up together. But do know, when you level up with somebody, you are wasting time. Because when you're doing a mission together and you're trying to leave, it takes a longer time for y'all both to leave. Now, if you're by yourself, you can pretty much finish the quest, click slash leave, or click forfeit the match when you're already done with everything. And you will be able to get the EXP, and then you'll save yourself time to actually go and get your next mission. So that's why I recommend, do not play with people in this game if you're leveling. Sure, there are certain bosses that are tough, and if you're a beginner at the game, there are certain bosses that are tough. Really, the bosses in this game that are only tough are pretty much some of the raids. Like in season one, it's only Inkels, and that is because Inkels literally has his minions chasing your ass left and right, so you can't really do much about that if you have low attack and etc. and etc. And there is in season one, which is Keegan. Keegan is not really hard. The only thing that is annoying about Keegan is his AoE move that will catch everybody if everybody doesn't dodge. So yeah, I do not recommend playing this game with people if you're just trying to level. If you're just trying to level, play by yourself. You'll save time and you will be able to go back and get your other mission, collect your mission, receive your mission, etc. and etc. and you'll get your EXP faster. So yeah, and also another thing, when you see a lot of quests around on your map here, when you see a lot of quests on your map, make sure you get all of them before you go and do one of your quests, because you don't want to be that person that just gets one quest, go to the mission board, go do that quest, come back, get the other quest, go to the mission board, do that. That is wasting time, and you're pretty much ruining your chance of even leveling up faster like everybody else. You see how the majority of the people in the game, they already have their stuff and etc. and etc. I'm not completely done. I'm only at 21.6, which is decent. But yeah, you see how some people get jealous, like be like, oh, I wish I had that and etc. and etc. Some of them, they do have other characters that have the majority of the enchantment scrolls and the gear. Like with me, I had the majority of my gear on my other characters. But you can also get that also. Do know the RNG is pretty bad in this game, but it's not that bad. Usually it would take a week to at least get a rank 7 scroll in season 2 and etc. and etc. Depending on how your luck has been. My luck has been pretty good these past couple of days, so I'm not really gonna go too much into that. But yeah, you can pretty much reach that level and all of that, and be prepared if you just level up. So yeah, don't play with people if you're trying to level up. You're just gonna be wasting your time. And I know we're gonna go into another thing. I know I'm going off topic and etc. and etc. I'm going off of my head, so if this sounds a little bit off and not scripted, that's because I don't do things scripted. Now, every mission that you do, you will be at the level required to do that. Until you hit into Ankel's here, you don't start, when you are finished with the regular story quests, you really don't start this yet unless you hit level 22. And that's pretty much going to be a slowdown for you. But that's the whole point of your submissions here. As you can see, I haven't really done every single one of them. I already set this up to go and get the flu, but I haven't been in Rothschild in about 3 days. So pretty much you're gonna have to do some of your side missions to actually get the level required to actually start the next mission. Now, the majority of these things you are gonna have to farm for, or if you have a lot of gold, you will buy them on the marketplace. Do know, because you're buying on the marketplace, they will be more expensive than you farming them there yourself. That's why you should have at least a little bit gold. If you're new to the game, you're gonna have to farm for the things. You can't just buy it if you're like new to the game and you don't have a lot of gold. Like by the time you hit here, you'll barely even hit 100k of gold. So my cat is bawling out there. He's not really my top priority right now at the moment. So yeah, you'll slow down when you go here, and then you unlock everything else, and then it won't really be much of a problem until you get to level 40. Do know that not every mission that you have here will get you the level that you need to actually start the next mission. There are going to be some missions in the other places that you will not be able to do because you are not that level. So pretty much you're just going to continue with your story. And pretty much when you get higher enough in level, you will unlock the rest of the things. And those are pretty much your side stories, your side missions. Side missions are important, but they're important to an extent. As you can see, I have a lot of them up here. And literally, I'm not that worried about like finishing season one's every single season one quest, because it's not really that important. Once you get out of season one and start season two, leveling up is just a whole lot simpler. And we will get into that in a good bit. So, pretty much, yeah. That pretty much explains everything over here. This is the last area that you will have to go when you are about to finish with season one Kolhem. And then you'll go into Rothjest. So pretty much, just do what I say. If you're trying to level in this game, don't play with people. Honestly, you're wasting time if you're playing with people and you're just trying to level. Just play the mission by yourself. If you die, make sure you join a guild so you can get a guild feather. That's if your guild is active. My guild is not that active because we are all over the world. And literally, it's only like the limit of how many people that would be on in my guild is about 10 people. Right now, as you can see, it's pretty early. Usually my guild members don't get on until late at night. When it's my time around like 1 a.m., it's like 5 or some shit a.m. for... No, it's like 5 or 6 p.m. for them. Because the majority of people that I play with are from the West. So, yeah. And plus, I'm on East server if you wanted to know. Because I know people are going to want to know that. Now, we're finished with Season 1. We're going to go into Kolhem real quick. I know that some of these will be pretty straightforward and pretty obvious to some people, but this is just to help out some people that don't know about the game. Now, we're going to go into Rothjest here. Okay, now we're in Rothjest. This is the second part of Season 1, so pretty much Chapter 2 or whatever you want to call it. It's not Chapter 2, it's like a whole lot more, but I don't really read the story. I got the quick summary on the internet, and that's pretty much all that is needed. So when you get into Rothjest, you will be around level 58 to 59. Like I've said, I think I said it earlier, but it only takes you an hour to reach level 45. And around level 40, you will be able to unlock your transformation, which is Paladin or Dark Knight. I usually go Paladin because it looks cooler, and pretty much it just gives... It just looks cooler. That's about it. I like Paladin. I don't really like playing Dark Knight. I don't really like Dark Knight that much. I really want it for my Herc because it looks better on the Herc than my Paladin on my Herc. So, yeah. So, unlocking your transformation is around level 40. You'll have to go to a guy in Rothjest to actually start this sub-quest. And with that subquest, you're going to have to go back and forth. It is a thing in this game a lot of times. You have to go back and forth. You have to spend money to go to Kolhem, money to go to Rothjest. Or if you can just wait the 5 minutes, which is not really worth it. So you're going to go back and forth and back and forth. You're going to do a mission in Kolhem, and then you're going to come back. You're going to go to the guy that you have to do the quest from in Rothjest. Then he's going to tell you to go back to Teeve, and then you're going to go to another place in Rothjest. Then you're going to go back to Kolhem. You're going to talk Kolhem, and then you're going to go straight back to Rothjest. You're going to talk in Rothjest, and then you're going to go straight back to Kolhem. I'm going to do a mission, and then you're going to go straight back to Rothjest. Yeah, I know it's a lot of back and forth. Like I said, you're going to go straight back to Rothjest, and then after you're done with Rothjest, you're going to go straight back to Kolhem, and then you're going to talk to one of the guys in the Mercenaries Outpost. No, not the Mercenaries Outpost. You're going to go to, you're going to talk to, is it Neil? Yeah, I think it's Neil. You have to go and talk to Neil. Then he's going to swear you into the Brotherhood, which you will be tested for. Then you're going to have to do that mission. Then you're going to go back to Neil. And then you're going to have to go back to the Mercenaries Outpost to talk to this guy. He's going to give you another mission. And then you're going to have to go back to him. And then he's going to give you a third mission, which pretty much is the unlocking of your transformation. And then you're going to go back. You're going to choose to either spare or kill him. Killing gives you Dark Knight, and sparing gives you Paladin. They are pretty much the same. They're really not that much apart. It's just that with Paladin, when you transform and you get into your second transformation, you send out these beams of light that do damage over time. And they pretty much don't really do much on that. And then with Dark Knight, you freeze the boss for at least about 15 seconds. Let's just say 15 seconds. I don't know the exact time, but it's about 15 seconds. Let's just say that much. And then pretty much you're golden with your transformation. The way how you're going to level up your transformation is pretty much just keep trancing. I really don't trance that much because it's not really needed for me. As long as I know how to survive. Let's put it like this. Every character I play with the game in the game, except for Lan, I don't know how to play Lan. I will never say I know how to play Lan. Lan is the hardest character for me to use. Not for everybody else, but for me to use. I can't get his Gliding Fury and his fucking crits down for nothing. So I gave up on trying to play him. Pretty much, each time you transform, you'll get, you'll gain points. And the points really, you'll get more points when you do, when you attack the boss or just do damage pretty much when you're transformed. And that's pretty much how you get points and et cetera and et cetera. You could trans at the last second of the raid's about to end, but you won't get as much points. That's why you'll see a lot of people, this as soon as the match starts, they trans. I mean, as soon as the raid starts or any boss battle or et cetera and et cetera starts, they usually just transform right there just so they could have the points towards the end of the raid or the quest or et cetera and et cetera. That's why you'll see a lot of people trans left and right. And you're just like, why did he trance? Did he waste it? No, they're pretty much just trancing so they can actually get their level of their transformation. And when you get to 40, you get a title and pretty much vice versa, etc. and etc. Now, I won't go into what you need to go. I can show you a quick little picture real quick. So let's click that baby up. Yeah, you're gonna see my desktop and everything else. It's not that important. So let's just go in full screen real quick. So as you can see, this is pretty much what I go for my paladin transformation. I usually have three here, two here, two here, one here, three here, two here, one here, three here, one deer. And that unlocks your second transformation. And then I go into my second path, and I have one here, two here, three here, one here, five here, of course, because you need to have five there, two here, three here, no, is it three? Yeah, three here, and then pretty much that's all of your points, and when you're level 40, that's pretty much how you're going to want to build your paladin thing. It's the same thing for Dark Knight. Pretty much, there's no difference. They're pretty much the same thing. It depends on what you want to do. I usually have this, so let's go into full screen again. I usually have this, so you can follow this if you want. It's your decision, but this is what the majority of people go for, and this is what I go for. Some people are going to disagree. They're going to say, put in more points in that, put more points in that, and that. You always need 2 points in that, but it's really not fucking worth it. They're just very stupid. So yeah, you can do that. And yeah, that pretty much explains Paladin. Now, into Season 3, into Rothchest. Into Rothchest. Every mission here in Rothchest, by the time of level 80 to 60, you'll hit level 60 without even trying. Honestly, it is that true. You'll hit level 60 without even trying. Every mission here is unlocked for you. There will be some missions that you'll not be able to unlock unless you do another mission. It will be really confusing when you get into the sewers, because sewers really doesn't start unless you start from sewers. Then it's going to go into it starts from ambush, then it's going to go into sewers, then it's going to go into vice versa. It's all over the fucking place, so you won't be going like one after another here. And then some of these you won't be able to unlock unless you do the sub quests or the side missions. Side quests, yeah. So that's pretty much it when it comes to Rothchest. Now, I'm not going to get into this. This unlocks when you're around Season 3. That is one of the bosses. So pretty much for the quests and the raids, everything here is pretty simple. You can pretty much solo everything except for Inkels, like I said. Inkels and Glass. Glass is a pain in the ass if you do not have attack speed. Honest truth. So these are pretty much the bosses that you'll be able to solo. You'll be able to solo Titan. Titan is not really even worth your time. He's a chump boss. You can solo him without even trying. It's just that you have to dodge him the majority of his moves. Because when he slaps you, he slaps the wind out of you. Slaps the fire out of your damn mouth. So yeah, when he slaps you, you'll pretty much not be able to use your stamina. And you'll be in that animation for a good bit. So yeah, that's pretty much it in Rothchest. The majority of every boss is simple. Until you get to Glass. And Inkels. So pretty much it's simple right there. Now, when you're done with Rothchest, you're gonna go straight back to Kolhem. And that's when you're starting to get into the final stage of Season 1. So I'll see y'all when we get to the board. Okay, now we're over here. I know there's all the people that have put up leveling guides on this game, but it's pretty much them just wasting a whole video just playing the game and leveling at the same time. It's just not worth it to make a video like that. So either way, when you're starting the final chapters of no, when you're starting the final chapter of season one, you'll start with this around Albie. You'll be fighting. No, the first person you'll fight pretty much is pretty much Shakar right here. Yeah, you'll pretty much be fighting him. He's a solo boss. You can fight him. He's not really hard at all. If you're new to the game, he is gonna be buried. He's gonna be difficult to you because it's gonna feel so hard to fight him. If I could put that, yeah, it's gonna be hard to fight him if you're new to the game. But do know his attack patterns are very simple. It's either he does three things. He charges you. He jumps back, charges you. He jumps back. He does a shockwave that literally is close range to mid range. So if you're far away, you won't get hit. And pretty much he'll just swing his mallet. It's pretty simple. And plus, if you're playing it on hard, it is so slow from hero. If you play it on hero, he'll just be constantly attacking, and you pretty much can't do hero unless you have attack speed, at least 60 and higher. Unless you're a Herc. When you're a Herc with 20k, you're pretty. Yeah, when you're a Herc with 26 attack, you can pretty much do whatever you want. Like, honestly, if you have 27k, no, 27 attack speed, which a Herc, if you get your awakening, which I will talk about because I am doing the video today for the Herc overview. If you have a 27 attack, it'll go up to 50 when you get all five of your awaken. So simple much. He's not really hard. Now, when you get into Shakar, you're gonna fight him. He's gonna give you that title. Then you have to fight him again tomorrow. Unless you have VIP, you just fight him again and you'll get the full title. You're gonna go back. You're gonna talk to this woman. Wait, let me see her face. You're gonna go back to Brennan's outpost, his lab. You're gonna talk to her. She's gonna tell you're gonna have to do the next thing, which pretty much is Betrayal. Betrayal is another very easy boss. It's Black Hammer. He's very slow with his attacking. The only thing that will be pretty hard for you is when you completely destroy his hammer, and he'll just keep charging you. But as long as you know how to dodge and block, like Piccolo always say, dodge, simple much, you will be able to beat him by yourself. You won't really need people to actually do this raid. Now going into the next one, the Evil One. Evil One, I do not recommend doing this by yourself if you're new to the game. Solo him on easy if you want to, but do know easy won't give you the EXP that you really need. That's why you will be fighting him on hard. And I do not recommend playing this by yourself if you're new to the game and if you have a lower level character. It's not worth it. You're just gonna be wasting your time because you are gonna be fighting two bosses in the beginning. You're gonna be fighting the lizard guy on his back. I don't know his name because I don't care. If you care, put it in the comment section below. You're gonna be fighting him, and you're gonna need bombs to throw at him so you can completely get him off his back. When you get rid of him, the raid becomes a lot simpler. But Lionotis is this guy's name is Lionotis. If you did not know, Lionotis is animations for everything is wonky. He is a very wonky boss. There are about two bosses in the game that are very, 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 very wonky. And no matter what you do, if you do not know what you're doing, you will get hit. So yeah, there is that. When you fight him, you're gonna have to go back to Brennan, and you're gonna have to talk to this woman, of course. Then after that, your side missions are gonna kick in. Once you're done with Rothchess and you go back to Brennan, you are gonna have to go and do Betrayal because there is gonna be another person that is gonna give you another quest. You're gonna have to go in to do Betrayal. Then you're gonna have to go to Rothchess back again to do Glass to get the chains that you're gonna have to bring back to Brennan. But when you do this and you go straight back to Rothchess, you are gonna talk to this girl, and she will pretty much send you to go to the cathedral. And when you go to the cathedral, you're gonna do an entire talking sequence, not really necessarily important. And then you're gonna go back to her, get your EXP, and then you're gonna go back to Kolhem, talk to Brennan, and get your EXP, and then pretty much you can do this again. But do know they've kind of removed getting VIP around level 60, because if you get VIP, you should really save it until you're at the end of season one, like towards the end, like the last chapter. That's where you use your VIP when you're when you're like low level, because you are gonna have to do this twice in one day. So pretty much it's best that you save your VIP. If you can get VIP, it's great. Now, when you do that, you're not gonna be doing Cold Rule the Golem yet, because you're gonna have to do this to get the stone to actually talk to the guy in the Mercenaries Outpost. This is gonna be a long ass video, I know. Then after that, you're gonna go back, you're gonna go to the inn, you're gonna talk to Keegan and Thieve. Thieve, I call her Thieve. You're gonna go back and talk to Thieve and Keegan. And then you're gonna start these missions: Earthborn Seal, Frostborn Seal, Timeless Rage, and Fate and Destiny. I'm gonna not really spoil Fate and Destiny for y'all. If you're new to the game, I want y'all to see what happens. So that is the final boss of season one. Yeah, it's this guy. So either way, Keegan was your friend and et cetera and et cetera. Darkness took over. If you have played Kingdom Hearts, you'll know what I mean. Darkness! Either way, going into it, you'll start with Earthborn Seal. Earthborn Seal, the majority of people will be hosting it. I'll say this right now, if you cannot host with more than 4 or 5 bars, if people join your boat and they only have 3 or 2 bars, or even 1 bar, don't host. It's that simple. If you can't host, don't host. You will pretty much be causing problems to everybody else, which is not worth it. So pretty much when you do all these raids here, you'll go back and then they'll pretty much pop up on your map, so you don't really have to worry. And then you'll pretty much do all the raids and then everything else. And then when you get to the end, this is the final thing of season one. You're pretty much done with season one. Now, I know a majority of people have been wondering, like, when they finish this and they go talk and et cetera, and they go see the animation, they go see the entire ending sequence and the cutscene. They're wondering, is that it? No, that is not it. You will be able to start season two soon. People may wonder, how am I going to be able to start season two? What do I have to do? Well, honestly, season two starts in like two different ways. Season two starts in two different ways. One, when you're done, you go and talk to this guy, any of them, depending on if you're on Rothchest or in Colheim, you talk to them, there will be a cutscene. Usually, that happens. If that doesn't happen, then you're going to have to go back to where Fergus is at, and you're going to have to talk to this woman in here. Okay, you're going to have to talk to her. And when you talk to her, you begin season two. Now, when you do that, you're going to go into season two, and I will see y'all when we get. Now we're in season two. Season two will start with that woman in season one. When you go there, she's going to tell you to come over here into Melina. Then you're going to go to the Coffee Chaser's Guild, and that's where pretty much the majority of your missions you will get. Now, this is when leveling up becomes easier, when you're in Season 2 and you can do Season 2. They have changed it up. Usually you would be able to start Season 2 when you're level 65 and lower. But now that everything now is 70 to 79, and 80 to 90, you won't start season 2 unless you're level 70. The majority of y'all will be around level 68 to 69 when you start season, when you're finished with season 1. All you're gonna have to do is pretty much turn in a couple of your side missions or do raids, because that's pretty much the only thing left for you to do to level up and get to level 70. Now, when you get to level 70, you'll come over here in Melina, and then you're going to talk to the Chaser. You're going to go to the Coffee Chaser Guild, and then they'll give you missions, and then you're pretty much just going to talk to everybody here in the whole fucking place, right? That is when leveling up becomes easier. You're going to start with this place here, and then pretty much Crescent Moon. You're going to start with Crescent Moon, then you're going to go down to Ship Graveyard, and then it's just going to go all over the place. These two here are pretty much just boss levels, like everything here. Boss, raid, etc., and etc., and etc. Now, this is when you are going to need this is when you're going to need Divine Blessings. There are two ways you can get Divine Blessings in this game. You can pretty much be playing with people that have the clover by their name. That event starts and disappears randomly, so when the event is going on, do the event, like join people that are have the clover by their name. The people that have the clover by their name are people that have not played the game for a very long while. So yeah, that's pretty much it. When you play with them and the raid is done and etc and etc and etc, you'll get these you'll get these return coupons, if I can fucking find them. You'll get these return coupons. 40 of these will give you VIP. All you have to do is go to the inn in Colhem and talk to the old guy. Most of these characters' name I can't remember because I don't keep them in my mind because they're not important that much to me. Go to the strange traveler in the inn in Colhem, and you can pretty much use these to get certain items. And when you have 40 or 45, you will get a VIP or a VVIP. I can't remember right now. It's not really that important. Or you can pretty much go there and get the divine blessings also, or luck blessings, EXP blessings, etc, etc. Usually most people would go with the EXP blessings because you're just trying to level. But divine blessings do give a lot more, and they pretty much give you everything. They give you AP, XP, and luck. So pretty much that's the whole point of the divine blessings. You are going to need them in season 2 to level up a whole lot faster. If you don't have them, pretty much you're just going to have to level the normal way and just play and hope that you get at least 1 mil or 2 mil EXP. With a DB blessing, you'll pretty much be getting 2 to 3 mil EXP each story quest. When it comes to the story raids, you'll get 4 mil EXP. So that's pretty much of that. There is another thing also. You can use your AP. That's if you have a lot of AP. But since you are in lower level, you're gonna not wanna do that. But if you can do it, do it. You can go to the old guy again in the inn in Colhem. You could pretty much use 200 of your AP to get a VIP, or you could use at least 100 of your AP to get some DB blessings. But that's your preference on what you want to do. If you're in lower level, you most likely are not going to want to do that because you're going to want to level everything up. Now, as you can see, I don't have everything level up on Delia because I'm not in a rush, and the majority of these are not important unless I get Will all the way up and the smash crit, etc, and etc. This is why I haven't done the Delia guide yet, because I want to get everything maxed out, but I have not been rushing. Right now, the moment, as you can see, my weapon is a plus 14 Leopard Valor Noblest Buster Sword. I'm going to try to plus 15 it, but in order for me to do that, I'm going to need AP up the ass, which, as you can see, I don't have at the moment. So pretty much, when you go there, you get your DB blessings, and then you're going to come into Season 2, and you're going to do the Season 2 runs by yourself or with people. Usually, I would say do it with people in Season 2 to actually not be alone and die, and when you die, somebody can pick you up. But at the same time, it's your preference. So when you get into Season 2, it is going to be a kind of a back and forth, but the EXP in Season 2 literally give you so much EXP. By the time you're done with Season 1, the majority of people are either level 78 or 79. Same thing like in Season 1. Depends on what you do. And I know everything looks weird. I just overclocked my PC, so I should have said that in the beginning, but fuck it. So yeah. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Get your DB blessings, do all your missions. You are gonna have to go back and actually like do runs to actually get certain things for certain sub missions. But other than that, very simple. Now in Crescent Moon, every boss here is easy, except for the Hive Queen. The Hive Queen, pretty much all you gotta do there, when you get to the Hive Queen and you bring her out and etc and etc, you're gonna bring her into this little corner. When you bring her into that little corner, it'll be a whole lot simpler because she won't have a lot of elevation to actually fly around. If you just fight her where she's at and in the middle, you're just wasting time, and pretty much the majority of your attacks will not hit her. So yeah, that's pretty much the only boss hard in the entire CM run. That's why people usually skip it. But now, since they've completely revamped the entire leveling and the entire run system, it's pointless. So either way, going into the next thing, Ship Graveyard. Ship Graveyard, every boss here is actually pretty simple. The only bosses that are hard are Mad Willy here and Long Boot Maddie. This bitch right here, we do not like her. And sorry if I'm being blunt as shit. That's pretty much how I am. Read the name, it's rudegamers.nicegamers. So yeah, these are pretty much the only three bosses that are actually annoying. This boss here, Barnacle Bill, he's not really annoying. The only thing annoying about him is that he has poison all around him. But after he's done with that entire poisonous session and pretty much swinging his sword, he will be on the ground for at least a good 20 seconds. And you can do as much attack as you can do before he gets back up and starts doing random shit. So yeah. That's pretty much easy right there. Now, we're going to go into the next thing. Twilight Desert. Usually people don't do Twilight Desert anymore because it's not really worth it. It does not give you that much EXP. It does, but at the same time, it's not really worth it because the RNG for this place is very terrible. Pretty much people will do this to actually get certain scrolls, like Starlight. If I remember correctly, Starlight drops in here or some shit. Can't remember. I don't do Twilight Desert anymore because it's not worth it. I only did it so I could get the title for the bosses. So yeah, pretty much every boss here is easy, except for this guy here, Ikram, Commander Ikram. This is the boss that everybody hates, no matter how high of a level you are. You could be level 80, 90, whatever. You could do 70 to 79 or 80 to 90. This boss is literally everybody's most hated boss. If you play with people in the Twilight Desert, or to pretty much just play this for the first time yourself, you will see why everybody hates this guy. His attacks make no damn sense, and he's a retarded boss to fight. So yeah, that's pretty much it on that. Now, like I said, the majority of everything will be simple. Now, I'm going to show you one of my story missions here because I am not done with Season 2. I haven't really been trying. Each story mission, like this one here, gives 1 mil, 100 mil and 3 whatever EXP, 1.3 mil EXP. Now, if you have a DB blessing, it will give you 2 point whatever, depending on which story quest you get. So pretty much, you will be able to level a whole lot simpler. Around the levels of 70 to 80, when you hit to 80 and etc. and etc. I'm going to be saying etc. and etc. a lot. That is my thing. I'm sorry if that confuses you or just gets you mad, but that's my thing. So yeah, when you're around level 70 in the levels of level 70, leveling is not really hard with the amount of EXP that you get. Plus, they've been having this double EXP weekend that has been going on because Delia's hit. Delia has only been out in North America for about 2.5 weeks. So they're doing a lot for her right now if you want to level up and hit cap and etc. and etc. So pretty much, the EXP, when you use a DB blessing, you'll pretty much get 2 mil, etc. and etc. And you'll be able to level. Each story mission gives you about 1/3 of your EXP bar at the bottom here, as you can see. And when you do that, you'll pretty much just level a whole lot faster. Season 2 is really where you go to level like super, super fast. So by the time you're done, you'll be starting to hit into these bosses here. Around the time when you get to these bosses, since you have 70 to 79, and if the people do that, there's a lot of people that have not done that because there is no point. Because majority of people have had their characters past level 70 now. Like, in the first day, people have hit level 90, which I think is not a good idea. Because I've played with those people, and they're the first one to die in a raid. So, that's why I say do not rush level when you're in the levels. So, either way, when you get into there, you'll pretty much get to these bosses here. When you're doing 70 to 79, pretty much people won't really care. Like, your attack should be 14k around level 70, 14 to 15. And pretty much if you're trying to do 80 to 90, because that's what the majority of people do, you're going to need to have at least 18k. And I know people are going to say, how do you get that attack? You pretty much just level. You get your weapon to at least plus 10 to 12. If it's a level 70 weapon, you are going to have it higher than that, depending on your star coin. If it's 2 stars, you're going to need to at least get that to plus 12 or plus 13. If it's 3 stars, you're going to need to get that to at least plus 12. And if it's 4 stars, you're pretty much just need to get that to plus 10 and pretty much just get your strength all the way up. And if you're playing as a mage character, get your int all the way up because that is important. So yeah, when you get into these raids and you want to do 80 to 90, people won't let you on a boat unless you are at least have 18k or up. There are certain people in this game that are not assholes. Like, there are a lot of people in this game that are assholes that just kick you for no reason. I was playing with a Karak 2 days ago. Like, I just randomly joined a boat. It didn't have people in there. I was in there for the whole time, and this Karak kicked me from the boat because I had more attack than him. I have never seen somebody so salty in my entire life. That's why I meant, like, there are certain people that are in this game that are fucking assholes. So, yeah. He literally typed it in the chat. You have more attack than me? Get the fuck out. And then that's literally what happened. So, blah. And I had a plus 14 from the levels of level 80. So he was salty and he was capped, so whatever. So yeah, there are certain assholes that will kick you off the boat, but the majority of people will let you in depending on your attack being 16 and up. If it's 16 and up, the majority of people will let you in. There's only like certain bosses that they will not let you join for, and that is Gateway of Hell, Lavasit, God of Death, Karam, and pretty much, where is he? Where is he? The Pinnacle. They'll let you in Deep Mines because Deep Mines, like when you're fighting Juggernaut, he's not really hard. But those are pretty much the three raids that nobody will let you in unless you have the attack and also know what you're doing. If you do not know what you're doing, on majority of these raids, there are a lot of tutorials on YouTube showing you. People have been playing this game for years. I've only been playing this game for 2 to 3 years now. You can take what I say with a grain of salt, but I play better than the majority of people that have been playing this game from launch, so blah. So yeah, when you're done, you're gonna be done with season 2 by the time you get to Crom, the God of Death. So yeah, when you're done with him, you're pretty much gonna be level 78. 78, that's if you're doing 70 to 90, and if you're doing 90, 80 to 90, you're all gonna be around 80, of course, because it is 80 to 90. Now, when you're done with season 2, pretty much all you're gonna have to do to start season 3, yes, we're getting to the third season now. All you gotta do to start season 3 is pretty much just go back to Kolhem, and usually it will pop up there for you. So let's go back to Kolhem and start the next stuff. Okay, we are back in Kolhem here. Kolhem, you're gonna have to go back. You're gonna have to talk to Brennan here. He's gonna tell you a mission, then you're gonna have to go to Rothchest. And when you go to Rothchest, etc., etc., you're gonna be doing this one raid. If you went back in the video, I kinda need water right now. If you went back in the video, you would see I was talking about another place that had another boss that he was like bluish, purplish, whatever you wanna see it. I'm not colorblind, people. He is a boss that you're gonna wanna fight around level whatever you hit, or whenever you're done with season 2. You're gonna have to fight him. The majority of people will fight him on hard and normal just to get the thing out the way, but he usually drops paradise stones, which you're gonna need to enhance your level 90 weapons. So you pretty much can fight him 2 times a day if you have VIP and just like farm your stones and etc. etc. Now, when you fight him, it's gonna be a whole commotion. You're gonna have to come back to Kolhem. You're gonna have to go to Brennan here. Then you're gonna talk to him. Mare is gonna be in the side there, and vice versa, and etc. etc. Now, that's when you fully start season 3. Yes, this is gonna be a hella long video. It's probably gonna take like an hour to render out. An hour and some change. An hour and some Obama, if you know what I mean. So yeah, you're gonna start season 3. You're gonna start with the Banchanner. They're gonna set up missions here for you, and vice versa, and etc. and etc. As you can see, I haven't started season 3 with Delia yet because I'm not rushing. I'm trying to get more attack. I'm trying to get at least 23k attack. So yeah, you'll pretty much get the missions. The majority of these missions quests here, you'll pretty much be doing them with people. You really are gonna want to wait for people. If you have the attack, by all means, fuck it, do it by yourself. But the majority of the time, you are gonna have to wait for people, because these bosses, they hit so damn hard. When I say they hit so damn hard, having 10k defense really doesn't even cut it for the majority of things you'll have to do in season 3. That's why people usually say go for 12k and pretty much 15k, and if you can hit 16k, you are pretty much in luck. The cap in this game, the majority of people will say for attack, the cap would be 24k, but that's bullshit. The attack cap that you can hit is at least around 28 to 29k, going into 30k, but we haven't had any updates in North America that will allow us to hit 30k. That's why the majority of people you see will have Like the majority of level 90s, like if they really are geared out, like fully geared, have max crit, max balance, max attack speed, which is around 100 and something, you will see them have 27k attack. And you may be wondering, like, how the hell did they get 27k attack? The majority of them are wearing accessories. Like the majority of everybody is wearing accessories and pretty much outfitter. You will not see another. You will not see a person that has 27k attack wearing no accessories and no and having none of these trinkets at all. Like, it. You cannot do it. You need these to at least hit 27k attack, and plus have a plus 15 and vice versa, and etc. and etc. Usually for season 3, having 23k to 24k is golden. You don't need more than that. You're pretty much set. You don't need anything else. So yeah. So if you see people have 27k and vice versa, they're pretty much having accessories on, avatar stuff on, and outfitters. That's pretty much how people get more attack when they hit cap, and vice versa, and etc. and etc. You know what I mean. I'm not going to go too much into it because I am running out of time. I don't want this thing to be an hour. And I got to render and cut stuff. So yeah. When you get into season 3... pretty much you are going to wait for at least one or two people to join. Depending on their attack, it will go great. Depending on if they know what they're doing, it will go great. Pretty much you are going to need chains for the sub-quests because the majority of the bosses do have effects that activate. Hold up real quick. Sorry if you heard that. I have no water here to drink. Either way, the majority of the sub-bosses in each and every place, they're pretty much the same sub-bosses over and over until you get into this place here. You're gonna need chains to actually hook them so you can relinquish their effects on you, which sometimes decreases your crit, decreases your attack, decreases your defense, and decreases your critical resistance. As you can see, my critical resistance is 72. Pretty much, if I get hit hard enough by a boss, I will die. And pretty much Life Flare will save your ass. I'll explain that later on when I do the guide. So yeah, pretty much you are going to just need chains or pretty much the flashbang, whatever bomb that you can get. But do know those pretty much don't work 95% of the time. Most of the time they are duds. That's why usually people would say, go and get chains. Like after you join them, or if they join you, they'll be like, do you got chains? Because you're going to need chains to actually hook the boss's legs. And I know people are going to miss the chains if you're new and you never used the chains before. But pretty much just aim for his knees. Aim for his knees and you'll pretty much just chain him. And it's that simple. So pretty much that's it. That's it when it gets into everything else. And pretty much that's pretty much how you level in this game. It is very, very simple to level in this game. I may have been talking for a good bit, but it is very simple to level in this game. So that is pretty much to help the people that have been commenting on my video being like, how do you level? How have you been leveling so fast? The majority of these are pretty much self-explanatory and people know. Everybody should know because it's pretty much right there in your face. So that's pretty much how you level. Just remember, if you are leveling, do not play with people. Playing with people will slow down your leveling up process. There are certain raid bosses and certain mini raid bosses that you will have to fight with people. But at the same time, when it comes to your normal story quests, play by yourself. You'll level up faster and you don't gotta wait on people, which is a chore. So pretty much people, once again, sorry for the coughing. That's pretty much how you level up faster in this game. I did not make two or three or friggin' five fucking videos explaining leveling up because that's fucking a waste of time and it's stupid. It's very stupid. You're wasting a video by doing that. So pretty much everything here is explained. That's pretty much how you level in Vindictus. It is very simple, very straightforward, and you don't really gotta do much. I explained pretty much how people get, attack and crit and everything maxed out pretty much in this game. Oh my god, I'm gonna be coughing a lot. Pretty much in this game, when you're enchanting your weapon, you are gonna need enchantment rooms or enhancement rooms, one of the two. I can't remember right now because I haven't enchanted one in a good bit. You're gonna need those. When you level up, when you enhance your weapon, when you get to plus 10, you will not be able to use roams on any of your gear. You're gonna have to YOLO. Most people say don't YOLO, but sometimes you just have to have that feeling. And if Forgus is on a very good day, if you're getting things like rank 7 scrolls, good drops, vice versa, and etc, etc, you're not dying in raids, you're surviving like a friggin' boss, then pretty much take your chances, go to Forgus, and YOLO in this game, and pretty much the majority of the time, you will get the things that you need. You'll pretty much get the enchants that you need, like the enhancement of your weapon and whatever, and your gear that you will need. The event went on a couple of days ago, sorry if you missed it. The event went on, it gave me a plus 12, plus 11, and I was like, fuck it, let's YOLO. Went to Forgus, got the weapon straight without even, like, doing any stupid tactics and rituals and etc, and got the weapon to plus 14. So that's pretty much what I did. That's pretty much how I got my plus 14. Lucky like that. Very lucky. So yeah, that's pretty much it. You're gonna have to take chances in this game. When you have like certain scrolls to put on your gear and etc, a lot of people don't take chances. But in order to succeed at this game, you need to take chances in this game. That's pretty much how it is when you level. So either way, people, that is pretty much explaining everything, how you level, how you hit cap. Do know you are going to need outfitters, or if you don't, you can't get an outfitter, you can't get an outfitter. You can pretty much hit at least the attack that people think are cap, but are not cap, but whatever. So that's pretty much how you level. Explaining everything, explaining the missions, and pretty much explaining how everybody gets their max attacks, max crit, and etc. You are gonna have to put money into this game to get stuff. Like, honestly, there are some people that are very lucky that they have not put a cent in this game, and they can get, they have gotten plus 15s, they have gotten they have gotten 5-4 stars, etc, and they have never needed to put a cent in the game. There are some people like that, but the majority of people are not like that. Some people have a lot of luck, and some people don't have a lot of luck. You could be doing runs for months, to get one thing. And then that one person joins you, or that one person does the one run, and they got it like there. Like the RNG, unlucky people, they lucky. Like the RNG in this game is not really that great, but it's not really that bad. There are a lot of people that have quit because the RNG is very disgusting in this game, but it is really not that bad. You just really gotta play the game and hope that that day that you're playing the game, you have a very lucky break. Now, me, I need to get a Thunder Ring, which I've been farming for 2 days. I haven't got it yet. I'm not that lucky. I have sometimes when I'm lucky, but at the majority of everything, I'm not really that lucky. Sometimes you could YOLO stuff, sometimes it will destroy your weapon or destroy your armor. That's why the point of AP. You can only boom things 2 times. So yeah, that pretty much explains everything. Hopefully this video has helped you out. I'm hitting my time, man. Things become a pain when it's your time, but either way, hopefully this helped you out, people. Later on this week, most likely Sunday, I will be able to, Sunday or Saturday night, I will put up the overview of the Herc guide, explaining more things that I left out in the Herc guide, and pretty much giving you some more tips that I have figured out playing with Herc for a longer period of time than when I did the guide. So either way, that is it. Hopefully this video helped you out, and good luck leveling, and pretty much have a good one, people. Peace.